I'm Nick Pettit.
I'm Jason Seifer.
And you're watching the Treehouse Show, your weekly dose of internets where we talk about all things web design, web development, and more.
In this episode, we'll be taking a look at Fokus, using Internet Explorer on your Mac, and a nifty bookmarklet called DOM Monster.
Let's check it out. First up is Fokus.
Nick, what do you think your favorite flavor of ice cream is?
Jason, let's try to stay focused.
Sounds good.
It's Neapolitan, by the way.
Neapolitan.
Yep. And Fokus is not spelled the way that you normally spell it. It's spelled F-O-K-U-S, and it's basically this nifty little piece of JavaScript that you can include on your web page, and when you go to highlight text, it will actually black out the rest of the web page and only show you the highlighted text. You could use this for a number of different reasons. Maybe if you're building web-based presentation software and you want to highlight something in particular, or if you're showing a web page and doing it like in a presentation format and you want to just show a particular piece of the web page, it's a really good way to do that.
I'm going to go with Cherry Garcia.
All right. Sounds good.
Next up, there is a new version of Flowplayer out. Flowplayer 5 uses the video element to display videos in HTML5. What's new in Flowplayer? Well, it is responsive, which is something that we all talk about on this show, I think a little bit too much. But Flowplayer is something that people used a lot before. What was great about it is that if HTML5 is available, it'll use that. If not, it can always fall back to using Flash to display video. Probably the best part about the new Flowplayer is it's very minimal and also very easily skinnable, as well as being very easy to use. So you can check that out at flowplayer.org, and we'll have a link to that in the show notes, which you can check out on our YouTube channel.
Pretty nifty. Next up is this really cool blog post from the BBC called Cutting the Mustard. Their website is Responsive News, but then there's this post called Cutting the Mustard, which basically describes this technique for progressive enhancement. Basically, the post is resorting to some old school methods that haven't been used in, I guess, not quite some time, but the author feels like people have generally forgotten about them.
In this age of bandwidth gluttony.
That's right.
We have to return to making our sites just a little bit more minimal.
So the author is describing this technique for just building the HTML for the most basic experience possible, and then adding JavaScript on top of that as an enhancement.
Right, and then I think he also mentioned using the native implementations if the browser supports it, rather than falling back to a huge library that maybe doesn't contain everything that you want.
It is really refreshing to see when, you know, there's so many libraries that are getting pretty huge and you have to include so many of them to build kind of a modern front-end experience.
Yeah, exactly. Blog post worth reading?
It's definitely worth reading. It is a little bit long, but we just gave you the TLDR, so you can go ahead and read more if you'd like.
Awesome. Next up, over on the OS X Daily blog, there's a really awesome blog post on installing Internet Explorer for the Mac the easy way. This is a way to run IE 7, 8, and 9 for free in a virtual machine.
Whoa, for free?
For free. Now, this is actually an old blog post, but since we are talking about, you know, progressive enhancement, it is kind of worth noting that you can still do this. There are free images provided by Microsoft for Windows with versions of IE 7, 8, and 9 on them. And then this is just a quick post detailing how to do that and use open source virtualization software to get that all set up on your Mac. So check that out.
Pretty nifty. So next up is this really cool website at webplatform.org. This is brand new, and it's basically all new documentation for the normal front-end web stuff that you would expect, like HTML, CSS, and more. This is all organized by the W3C and a number of other big-name companies, and it's just basically really good documentation. It's a kind of a community project, so at this stage, it's a little bit rough. I looked at actually the header element in HTML5, and there was hardly any documentation there. But I would imagine all that stuff is going to get filled out pretty quickly.
Yeah, they're working on it. Right now, it's just basically an import of content that was already on Microsoft's site, Google, you know,
Mozilla
site.
Docs.
Their goal is to have one centralized spot for knowledge about the latest standards from, you know, a lot of the browser vendors that implement them. So it looks like a really worthwhile project. So go ahead and get involved with that if you can.
Very cool stuff.
Next up, we have a piece of JavaScript called KeyMaster. This is really awesome. It's a simple library for defining keystrokes in JavaScript. This can actually be a really cumbersome thing to do when writing web pages. So you get this one global method called key, and you can pass key a string, and inside of that string you can abbreviate the different keystrokes that you want, and then pass it a function, and this will go ahead and call that function every time that key is pressed. This is very useful for abstracting away shortcut keys inside of your application, and just having one common interface is very easy to do rather than having to look up the key code all the time, although we did cover what the key code on a previous episode.
That's right, that tool where you could go ahead and look up key codes really quickly. And that's helpful, but this is perhaps even more helpful.
We're always one-upping ourselves here on the Treehouse Show.
That's right.
Or are we?
Next up is DOM Monster, which is a project from Thomas Fuchs and Amy Hoy.
You sure you pronounced that name right?
I'm pretty sure I pronounced it just right. Thanks, Jason. Basically, it's just a little bookmarklet.
Scary.
That you can grab and put into your bookmarks toolbar. And of course, yeah, it has this scary little monster there.
It's really scary.
So I'm going to go ahead and bring up my bookmarks toolbar and hit DOM Monster, and bam!
Bam!
We have this little console, and it tells us basically some diagnostic information about the web page, and it gives us some tips for improving front-end performance. So in this particular case for the DOM Monster page, it says reduce the number of tags that use style attributes. There are 199 bytes of inline JavaScript code, which is actually not much at all, but you know, really pretty handy, and it's super important to get front-end performance as fast as possible, especially in this age of mobile devices.
Agreed. I like the icon, even though it scares me a little bit.
It's just in time for Halloween.
So next up, we're going to be talking about Compass.app. In another episode, we talked about Compass, which was a little framework for generating and working with CSS. One of our members pointed out Compass.app, which is an app for working with Compass. And so what this will do is it'll give you a little interface for working with Compass, and then it will automatically update inside of your browser and just kind of compile everything as it needs to be compiled. This is a $10 application, but 30% of the proceeds go to charity. So check that out at compass.handlino.com.
And that is a pretty nifty feature, because oftentimes when you're developing with you know, tools like Compass or SAS, you'll have to go ahead and refresh the browser constantly. And
right.
There's a big, you know, back and forth. So it's pretty cool that you can see those results as you're developing.
Definitely worth $10.
Very cool.
Not sponsoring the show.
Shame
just,
on them.
Just to make that clear, yeah.
Next up is this really cool font from Adobe called Source Code Pro. And there's not a whole lot to say about this. There's a pretty nifty blog post where they talk all about the advantages of using Source Code Pro over other fonts in any text editor. But, you know, it's just a new font that is worth trying out. I think it looks pretty nice. It looks like it's a little bit more proportionally spaced, but also, you know, monospaced at the same time, which is what you want for coding. So pretty cool. I like it.
It's nice. I like their color scheme.
Yeah.
You know, your choice of source code font is a very, very personal choice. So try this on. If it doesn't work out, you don't have to keep using it.
It is a very personal choice, because it's going to be something that you're working with all the time. So.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I think that about wraps things up for this episode of the Treehouse Show. Jason, did we learn anything today?
Not really.
No?
No. We learned that there are some pretty interesting tools for working with Compass and DOM Monster. That's pretty neat.
All right.
Other than that, I learned practically nothing.
You learned my favorite flavor of ice cream.
That's true. That's very important.
And you were thinking Cherry Garcia?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, I am.
Got it.
So thanks so much for watching this episode of The Treehouse Show. For show notes and more, check out our YouTube channel at youtube.com/gotreehouse.
And if you'd like to follow us on Twitter, I'm at NickRP.
And I'm at JSeifer.
And of course, if you'd like to watch more educational videos like this one, you can check us out at teamtreehouse.com. Thanks for watching.